Hey everybody, it's Bryan from Because Why Not, back again to make a new video. Today we are doing black beans, and these aren't going to be your basic black beans. They're going to be a lot healthier. They don't have any lard in it, they don't have any oil in it, they don't have any butter in it, they don't have any fat in it, but these are fantastic. I honestly didn't like black beans until I had these, and I hope you give them a try, and I hope you love them too. Thanks.
So like most of my recipes, we're going to start out with some onions. We're of course going to chop them in half, get the ends off, cut them in quarters, and then cut them in eighths, because I am going to use quite a fancy little tool. I think you've all heard of it. It's this chopper. Makes cutting really easy, makes cutting into real small pieces really easy, especially if you don't care how small the piece is. And as you can see, it works really well. It is incredibly loud and it shakes the camera if you happen to be filming, of course, but if not, you don't need to worry about it. And this is look at that, it broke. So as a backup, you should always have a knife around to finish the cutting, like I do here. So try to just make them as small as possible. Try to match the size of the other onions, and you should be good, because it doesn't matter, because they're going into black beans, and nobody's going to see what the onions look like, right? So the recipe originally calls for cayenne pepper to be put into these beans, but I have a serrano pepper plant in my backyard, and you know, when you have serrano peppers, make serrano aid. Or just chop them up real fine and put them in your black beans, because it'll make them spicy, it'll add that little pepper kick, and it'll be delicious. Just don't rub your eyes after this, please. Take my advice. Please don't rub your eyes or any other parts of your body. Once you're done masterfully chopping your vegetables, you're going to put some black beans, I have two cans here, low sodium of course, in a pot, and you're going to turn that on high, and then you're going to very carefully, not messy at all, put these vegetables in the pot with the beans. Shocking, I know, right? What actually is even more shocking is the gratuitous amount of stirring of these beans and onions that I am including in this video. But you know, you gotta make sure everything's mixed as it comes up to a boil. You don't want onions only in part of it, do you? That's not good. After about 5 minutes of boiling, your dish is essentially done. So if you're done cooking the rest of your meal, go ahead and turn the heat off. If not, like I was, I'm just gonna put it to a low simmer and add the rest of my ingredients. The rest of my ingredients, of course, being chopped cilantro. What? I know, right? In a Mexican dish? Shocker. Again, shocker. There's a lot of people that hate cilantro, but don't hate it. It's delicious. Just add it. It'll make the whole thing better. And then garlic salt. You don't really need salt, but, you know, I needed garlic, and I didn't have any cloves, so this will have to do for now. And, of course, more gratuitous stirring. But seriously, at this point in the cooking, it's done. So you just go ahead and taste it, and hopefully it has the right amount of spice. If not, go ahead and add some cayenne, which I did. Didn't video it, of course, because I didn't want you knowing I made mistakes, even though I just told you. Huh. And you know what? That's not making a mistake. That's making my food better. Tasting it, adjusting, doing what I have to do to make sure that I enjoy this meal. And I hope that's what you take away from this, as you're looking at what I actually did with these beans. I'm not just going to eat them straight up, although you could, because they're that delicious. But I took some rice, put them beans on top, had some slow-roasted pork, finished it off with, you know, some extra cilantro, and tomatoes, and sour cream, and cheese, and you gotta get you some. Make it, for real. Video's over. Thanks for watching. I hope you watch more of my videos. I hope you give this one a try. And I hope you like it.